Assalaamu alaikum sisters, I hope you're all doing well. In this video, I want to share with you my summer essentials for covering ladies. So in a nutshell, how to survive this intense heat while still being covered. A little disclaimer at first, I know some people handle heat differently than others. Some people can handle very high heats without blinking an eye, and some people just can't that much. So just always remember that these tips are just tips and preferences or suggestions, and you're welcome to adjust them according to your preferences and your likings. So let's start with fabrics and silhouettes. For high heats, you want to choose something lightweight and flowy and airy. For example, this Dustin Collection's lightweight fabric. This lightweight fabric is really good in the summer. It really keeps me cool. Another fabric style, for example, from other brands have been light microfiber. Many sisters have said that that really works for them. Light microfiber. I believe it's also called somewhere wool peach. I believe so. So it's also very thin, very lightweight material that doesn't sew through, but it really keeps you cool, and it's very lightweight on your head. If you're wearing a Khimar or jilbab that you're putting it on your head, then it really feels also very lightweight. Also, another fabric that I really suggest that you having is Nida. So N-I-D-H-A, I hope I pronounce it right. So Nida fabrics just came, I think, a couple of years ago, and many manufacturers are now selling them. It is this very flowy, very cooling, very fluid material that has a slight sheen to it. And you will see it in the clip here. It just reflects light that nicely. It's not shiny, but it has this sheen to it, if you know what I mean. It looks and feels like water, really, seriously. Like when you put it on and if it's high heat outside, it really feels light and airy and almost cooling. Compared to, for example, when I'm sometimes wearing this lightweight, compared to Nida, the Nida is definitely more cooling material. So if you want to compare between the sheen of the Nida, this is, okay, let me show you this one. This is the lightweight fabric and this is the Nida. I'm not sure if you can see, it actually has a slight sheen to it. So this is like in a light shadowy place, and obviously this is an unlight, lighter color. This one is so flowy and so lightweight that you do really want to have something like that. Don't get the caviar that I usually suggest in some of my videos. I really love caviar, but that's not gonna work for you in the summer. You're gonna cook. So don't get something heavy. And if you're not sure, you can always ask around from people and online and ask the manufacturers themselves, how do you think that the lightness of the fabric is? I'm not an expert in fabrics, but if you have any suggestions what fabrics really work for you, please do put them in the comments box below. Then let's talk about silhouettes. And what I mean with silhouettes is the shape of your garments. The idea or the goal is to have the least amount of fabric tightly, directly on your skin. And the flowier the fabric is or the clothing is, the more airflow it's gonna have underneath. So it's almost gonna act kind of like an air conditioning. So once you see these, sometimes these really big malhafas that they start from the head and go all the way down, or these big overhead jilbabs or something, it's daunting looking. It looks like you're cooking in it, but it creates this airiness around your body, between your body and the fabric. Think about big and flowy and the least amount of garment pieces as you can get. For example, you can have just a big overhead, long overhead abaya or a malhafa, which I'm probably gonna throw in the video here. So it's an overhead abaya that goes from all the way from head to toe. It's very flowy around your head and your arms. The armholes can be very big and open, so the air gets in from there. You can pair it with the maxi dress under it. Just a maxi dress with strap shoulders. So it really creates the airflow inside. The idea of that fabric is that it blocks the sun from coming to your skin, which makes this cooling effect. Also, it should be open from down. It's better to prefer skirts rather than pants, even salwar pants, because with salwar pants, the foot is, or the ankles are like this. So you can see the air doesn't get in from here. But if it would be like an open skirt or something, like a big airy flowy skirt, then the wind and the air gets to go in from there and actually flow around your skin between the fabrics. And the flowiness of the fabric when it does like this around your skin, it also creates kind of like this cooling effect on your skin. Believe me, it works. Obviously, with malhafas like that, if they have a big head opening from here or big sleeves, how you want to then cover yourself or keep yourself covered. You can have like a very thin shayla under it. Obviously, I've usually paired my malhafas with light shayla and a niqab, and then just put the malhafa on top. Then I might have like a maxi dress under, and then I have my gloves. And if you're not wearing gloves or something and you're worried that your arms might be showing because of the big sleeves, you can always wear separate sleeves. You can find these in the markets almost anywhere in every color that you can possibly get. So these are like very thin material separate sleeve. It's weird, I know, but these are not very hot. Like, you can wear straps and a very loose jilbab, and if you don't want to show your arms, obviously, then you can just have this one under the sleeve, so you don't have to worry about your sleeve falling off and your hand showing, for example. So these are very handy. You can get them almost everywhere in different styles and colors and materials. I really like these ones. If the big malhafas are not your thing, then you can always choose like a shoulder abaya with like this type of separate big khimar. If it's shoulder abaya, make sure it is very flowy from down. For example, this one, not a good idea. It has more like a defined sleeve, but if it would be like one of those bigger like Beige abayas that like I showed in my Beige abaya lookbook, go have a look at that, then it would work better, because you don't want to usually have something that directly on your shoulders, even under the khimar, because it blocks the airflow from coming to your shoulders, and that can feel suffocating for some people. Even if your clothes are very lightweight, that can be suffocating. But if you want to wear like a shoulder abaya, pair it with big flowy khimar and make it extra flowy, the abaya extra flowy, so the cut is very big and loose. So then it also gonna have, think again, big flowy airy air conditioning, so that the air gets in from the sleeves, the air gets in from down and from all around, all the way up to your belly button, even on your shoulders, on your neck, so that the air gets to go around. That's another thing why I don't necessarily recommend of wearing a shayla, even a nice thin shaylas in the summer, because you're wrapping it around your head instead of compared to, for example, khimars. Because under here, you don't have to have any fabric under here, but this is like flowy and airy, so the air gets to go from under here, it gets to go all the way to my neck, around my head area here. So you get my point. The third style would be like a two-piece jilbab with a skirt and a top. So then the air again gets to go all around. Just make sure that the skirt is very flowy. And with jilbab tops like that, or with jilbabs, two-piece jilbabs like that, you don't necessarily even have to put a shirt under it. Like, you can just have your like whatever top you have, and then you don't have to have a shirt, because then it just blocks. Because when you wear a skirt, it kind of like blocks the air from coming to your stomach if you're wearing a shirt over it as well, which gets us to our next point. So what to put under your Islamic clothes then? Like I said, you don't necessarily want to have something of a top or a shirt under, but if you don't feel comfortable of being completely without a shirt under your jilbab, then use crop tops, for example. I found that very flowy, thin, lightweight crop tops really work. They give me that extra kind of confidence of wearing a shirt or something, but then they still let the air flow really freely under the clothes. So that's a really good idea, for example, with jilbabs, or I've used it with malhafas too. So if you're brave enough, if you feel comfortable enough, so you can have the crop tops under it. If you don't feel like being with crop tops or some skin showing, you can always use like sport tops. Very lightweight, fast drying sport material tops are really handy, because then they transfer the sweat against your skin, so then you will feel very cooling. So if the crop tops are not your thing, maybe the sport tops might be, with the sport fabric that will make you feel extra pleasant under. So what about the feet? Let's cover the feet. If you think about heat and socks together, your feet immediately start boiling, even just the thought of it. But I figured out a way to get around this a couple of years ago. I found these knee-high socks that are made from very lightweight, like stocking material. So the idea is, these are not your regular knee-high socks that you can get from H&M or something with the cotton and stuff. Don't buy those. Those are gonna kill you. But these are, the idea with these is that it's supposed to be very thin kind of stocking material. You can get these from your stocking sections, wherever is stocking tights, whatever you want to call them. and you can find these sold. The idea with these is that you want to get them as opaque as possible. With tights, they usually tell you the opacity by saying how many deniers it is, or how thick the fabric is. So the bigger the number of the deniers, the more opaque it is. For example, these are number 80. I suggest that you don't go lower than 60, because then the skin really starts to show through from them. So the cool thing about these is that they completely cover your feet. They keep you very cool and lightweight, so you don't necessarily have to wear any long pants under your skirt to cover your feet. The extra cool thing about these is that they dry pretty fast. So I've been even splashing in the water with these and cooling myself down, and then waiting for them to dry just a little bit before putting my shoes on. And it's been amazing, because then you can actually cool yourself down, you can splash in the water, and you don't have to worry about actually having wet socks on you. I will link some suggestions down below in the description box for all the items that I'm talking about in this video. Maybe they help you find these products in your local area as well. The last tip, what to put under your jilbabs in a heat, is lace underscarves, or very thin, very cooling material cotton underscarves. I figured this out a couple of years ago, and for me, I'm the kind of person that I can't wear any scarf, jilbab, khimar, anything without having an underscarf. Otherwise, it's just gonna flip over my head and my hair is gonna come out and it's all messy. So I figured out lace underscarves. Those save me a ton of stress in the summer. I'm not gonna show them in the video, because they actually honestly look like a little bit like underwear, because they are made from lace. But imagine this, it's tube underscarf made from lace. I'm sure you can find them somewhere in your local area, in your local stores. I will try to link something down below so you might have a little bit of idea what I'm talking about. But it is like a tube underscarf that it's lacy, because then it actually prevents the hijab or the clothing to flip over your head, but it, without adding any extra padding on your head, because you do not want to have any extra fabric on your head because you're already feeling hot. So do have a look at that if that's something that you're struggling with. And maybe I try to find also something cooling material, lightweight cotton ones as well. Now that we covered all the clothing related tips, let's jump into a couple of bonus tips. This next tip is especially directed to my Niqabi sisters, and that is sunscreen. I know what, my hijabi sisters, you remember probably to put sunscreen on your faces because it's on the show and it's just normal to protect your skin. But if you're a Niqabi sister, and if you're like me, I forgot to apply sunscreen for years after starting wearing niqab. It was only after I burned the bridge of my nose that I realized that, of course, it is exposed to the sun all the time, so I need to put some sunscreen on it. Then again, I also realized that I get sometimes in weird places, like, how does it even get here? But I get like tanning. I'm not getting like tanning lines, like I'm not getting anything like that, but I just realized that it gets slightly browner or tanned from this part, and this part. Very cute. It looks like pigmentation marks and it just looks weird. Anyway, I'm okay with that, but what I realized that I don't want to burn my skin anymore, so I bought some sunscreen. And the good thing when you're covering everything else in your body except the nose of your bridge, basically, is that this is the amount of sunscreen that you can need. This is the only thing that I need. Literally, this is just a tube. Just a tube. I mean, seriously. I've never used this little of sunscreen ever in my life. See? I just wipe it with my finger, put it in here, maybe in here, if I'm not lazy, before I put my niqab on, and I'm out the door. So this is very handy. It comes cheap and cheaper than usually, but even no matter if you're wearing niqab or not wearing niqab, always remember to have an SPF on you. Another thing about sun is that how to protect our eyes then. I was struggling with this a little bit. In the beginning when I started wearing niqab, I used to always wear the flap niqabs, so they would automatically kind of like shade my eyes, so I didn't even think about this one. But after I stopped using them regularly, I kind of was exposed to this idea that, okay, I can't really see much. Like, I'm squinting all my life like this. How is the sun gonna burn my eyes? How is it gonna affect my eyes? And because I can't pull off the sunglasses, I know a lot of sisters can pull that look off, but I just can't. I mean, seriously, I know, right? I know some sisters can really pull this off and make it look nice and not feel weird about it. I feel self-conscious if I'm wearing sunglasses like this. These are even like decent, like these actually match the niqab and the khimar, but I mean, what is this doing in here? I just don't know how to use these. And I know some sisters can really pull it off, but this didn't work with me. So I had to come with something else. Let's just take them off. Okay, let's just put these back where they came from. So I had to figure out something. Then a couple of years ago on my Instagram, I saw a one sister wearing a sun visor. Visor, how do you want to say that? I called it a lid in my other video, but that's so wrong. Many sisters can pull off the really cool sun hats, and that's a good thing. Also, you can start wearing sun hats. Many sisters can make it look really nice, and it really works for them. Sometimes at work I've been wearing a cap, and that really works for me there, but then in the heat that's just an extra layer of fabric on my head, and I just don't want to have that. Until one sister showed me this visor that you saw already on my other video, and it's this. It's so cool because it's like open from here and doesn't have any fabric here. So the idea with this one is that you just put it on like so. So you look extra cool. I started wearing this at first to kind of not quench my eyes from the sun and kind of protect my eyes from the sun, until I realized that it actually creates a shadow or shade on my face, which is extremely cooling. If you think about it, it's kind of like sitting in the shade in the summer that cools you down the same way. This one just creates the shade only on your face, so only on your niqab, for example. Especially with niqab, it is huge difference when I'm not wearing this and when I am. So the feeling on my face is extremely different, and it's very lightweight and handy to use. If you're living in a very, very high heat country, I'm not blaming you for wearing umbrellas if you're going outside. When we used to live in Egypt, there used to be almost close to 50 degrees in the sun in the summer. And I know many, many places nowadays, they have a lot higher than that. But I remember if I would have to walk a longer distance outside, I would have an umbrella, because you need a shade in that heat. You need a shade. So extra tip, have an umbrella. It looks weird, but when it's high heat, no one's gonna judge you. As a matter of fact, I think they want to be under that umbrella with you. And yes, you might know what song I'm talking about. Shameless, Nina, shameless. I guess that was pretty much it. And of course, I didn't mention the obvious: always hydrate, always have water on you, and always remember to drink it even if you don't feel thirsty. Always remember that the thirst is the last warning sign before you pass out. And if you're in a really high heat, in a public transportation or something, have a fan with you. Electric, manual, or just a piece of paper, just to fan yourself. So those are my tips for surviving in heat while covering up. I hope this was informative and helpful for you. I hope I didn't leave something out. If you have anything to add to this, please put them in the comments box below so we can all benefit from them. We are always taking some advice from everybody. How do you keep cool in heat? So without further ado, I see you in my next video, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.